Hi everyone, my name is Melissa van Dijk and I tested Paula's Choice 10% Azelaic Acid Booster on my right side of my face and on my left the Ordinary Azelaic Acid 10% Suspension for an entire month. So you can call it a split face study. Now I wanted to see if both products could help me to reduce the redness, to reduce the look of blemishes, to brighten and even out my skin tone over that period of time. And there is quite a price difference between those two, but we have to also keep in mind that both include 10% of azelaic acid. So I do not only wanted to see which one performs better, but also what would the changes be when also using it for an entire month. And the way that I also used it was daily, in the morning and evening. And I kept it very basic and very simple so that we really can see the effect of azelaic acid. And so I just went ahead and washed my face with a Cetaphil Gentle Skin Cleanser, used azelaic acid booster and azelaic acid suspension on my face. And as for my moisturizer, I used the Roche-Posay Toleriane Ultra Fluid. And that's basically it. That's what I've used also for that entire month. And over that period of time, I also did take pictures, not only from the front of my face, like overall the face, but also from my mouth, since this is where I suffer from the redness, and also the sides of my face, so that we really can see the performance of both products. And so I want to get started with also the front pictures where you can see my face overall. And here you can also see day one as well as day seven. Now you have to remember that I also applied Paula's Choice on my right side, which would be your left when also watching the video, and the Ordinary Azelaic Acid on my left side, which would be your right side. And so that's why I also did mention on the bottom of the picture PC for Paula's Choice and TO for the Ordinary, so that we are not getting confused. And so during the first week of application, I do have to say there's not much of a difference except that I did get one or two blemishes, which you can see on day seven, and also a little bit more of that like brightening effect, especially on my cheeks. Those are like the main differences that I could see over that time, which you can also see in the picture when also looking at it. But then if you're also going to have a look at the close-up when it comes to the mouth area, this is also where you will see that I do suffer from blemishes sometimes as well. Now, I'm not 100% sure if at that time it also played a big role of what product I was using on what side, since I did get a bigger breakout on the Ordinary side and just a few like little ones also on the Paula's Choice side, but nothing too severe where I now also would question it. But I will get into that specific topic later on. But this is where you can see the comparison. Now I did notice one big change also when having a look at the close-up, and this is also on the Ordinary side on day one. You can see that I had flaky skin around my mouth area and chin and jawline, whereas on day seven of the Ordinary side it is gone. So that's a big improvement already over that week of using azelaic acid. It wasn't the case with the Paula's Choice side, so I can't really compare it, but you can see a clearly like big difference to day one to day seven on the Ordinary side. And then if you have a look at day 14 and day 21, I do have to say that's a time which I really enjoyed, because you can see that my skin looked even out, that it also started to get that brightening effect. You can see my like skin is also reflecting back to like the camera, which you mainly see on my forehead and cheek and a bit also on the chin area. Now, if you're going to have a close-up at my mouth again from day 14 and day 21, you can see that the breakouts calmed down and my skin around my mouth looked actually pretty great. And I was really happy over that time to also see the improvements happening. And this is only by using it for 2 to 3 weeks over that time. And then if you're going to have a closer look at what my face looked like on day 21 as well as day 28, on day 21, again, this is where it started to also look great, even though it no blemishes, like the redness was kind of alright, it was at a great balance. But then on day 28, like which was kind of like the last week of using the azelaic acid products, I'm not sure what has happened over that time. but I did experience more breakouts on the Ordinary side compared to the Paula's Choice side. Like with the Paula's Choice side, again, I just had one little pimple on my chin, as well as also on my cheek. But with the Ordinary, I was suffering, which you can still see right here, with like little bits of breakouts, which are really stubborn and do not really disappear that quickly. Plus, I also do experience loads of breakouts right here along my jawline and also neckline, whereas on the other side, this isn't the case. So I'm not 100% sure if this has something to do either with my hormones, because I do get blemishes, this is nothing new. But it's strange that it happened mainly to the Ordinary side and not so much with the Paula's Choice side. So this is something that I'm still questioning. But if you're going to have a look at the close-up from day 21 to day 28, you can see, again, my mouth area looks pretty great on day 21. But again, it started to flare up in breakouts and blemishes on day 28. And then if you're going to compare it from the entire month, what my face looked like on day 1 to compare to day 28, overall, I feel like I got that luminosity, that brightness also on how it evened out my skin tone, but I do still have blemishes mainly on the Ordinary side, which only happened over the last week by the end of the month. So this is what you still have to keep in mind. Whereas also on the Paula's Choice side, it kept my skin pretty clear and also was really satisfied with that result. And then if you're going to compare it from day 1 to day 28 with a close-up of my mouth, again, you can see the dryness around my mouth on day 1 on the Ordinary side, but it's basically gone on the Ordinary side from day 28. So ignore the fact that there are blemishes, but the dryness really improved. And with the close-up, you really can see that with my cheeks, which are like just on the picture, as well as my chin, it started to really brighten, like to reflect the light, which is something that wasn't the case on day 1, but it started to also glow and also brighten my skin tone a bit more over that entire month. So when it comes to the brightening factor, I do have to say that I find that there is still an improvement, and it also did brighten my skin tone, which you can also see clearly when I'm giving you the pictures from one side where I used Paula's Choice. Here you have the comparison from day 1 to day 28. Again, it's mainly also in this specific case, because I turned my hat, my cheek. It wasn't as bright on day 1 to compare it with day 28. So the brightness really did happen over that time. And I do find that my skin also looks a little bit more smoothened out and also even in that specific case. And then on the other side, from day 1 to day 28, looking at the Ordinary side, there's also a brightening effect. It isn't as strong compared to the Paula's Choice side, but you can see, mainly on my cheek, that on day 1 it was pretty matte, but you can also see on day 21 the brightening effect. And I do also really like the result of it also during that entire month. And then also what I do want to emphasize is how I mainly use them and also how my experience was while I was using them. So since I use them daily in the morning and evening, and I kept going with using on my right side azelaic acid from Paula's Choice and on my left the Ordinary azelaic acid, I did notice that feeling wise and also how comfortable I felt with the products, that I preferred azelaic acid from Paula's Choice, mainly because also on how I could spread it on my skin, how the texture basically feels, and also that it gave me a little bit more of a better effect. Like, I haven't had that many issues with blemishes. There was one or two like really little blemishes which were gone the next day, kind of like that scenario. So I was really satisfied with the Paula's Choice azelaic acid. But I do think, where I'm not 100% sure, either it may be my hormones that it just happened to cause the breakouts on my left, and it has nothing to do with the product. Or it may be because the Paula's Choice azelaic acid 10% booster does contain a bit of salicylic acid. I'm not 100% sure how effective this combination is when I'm also comparing it to the Ordinary side. Since with the Ordinary, I do find that the Ordinary may be a bit more suitable, let's say, for people that have kind of oilier skin, since it is a suspension, has kind of like that really dimethicone, like silicone-like feeling, which if you're going to spread it out, it's going to improve the brightness over time, but when also applying it, your skin in general looks already a bit matte. Whereas with azelaic acid from Paula's Choice, it doesn't make your skin look like looking so matte. So this is also maybe depending on your skin type, you may prefer one or the other. But at that point, I do feel that feeling-wise, how I could apply them, my experience with both products, I would go with the Paula's Choice one. I know that there's a big price difference, but when it comes to the comfort, like how comfortable it feels on the skin, and also how effective it was, how my experience was with the product, I do want to stick with the Paula's Choice Azelaic Acid. And I do also want to mention that since Azelaic Acid also does claim to reduce redness, which I'm not 100% sure if this was the case with my mouth, since this is also where I have the redness. And I do feel like the redness, generally speaking, comes and goes. It's like a flushing that sometimes appears, like it's stronger, and then it goes back to a little bit more, like less visible. So I'm not 100% sure if azelaic acid did something in that specific case with my issue around the mouth. But I do want to share also my experience while I was using them. Even though they have both 10% of azelaic acid in it, for some reason I always experienced like kind of like a stinging situation for a moment with the Ordinary one. Maybe because of the formulation, since it's so simple, it may be kind of like stronger, even though it includes 10% of azelaic acid. Whereas the one with Paula's Choice, because they also include like loads of different ingredients as well in it, that it may be less strong in that specific case because of the formulation. Because every time I use the azelaic acid from Paula's Choice, I did experience a bit of itching, like sometimes around here. And what's quite interesting is that it always happened where I have the redness. I've never had itching on my forehead or also on my cheek whatsoever. It was always around this area where I had the redness. And then after a few minutes, it went away. With the Ordinary one, it was more like itching. It was kind of like burning for some time. And I guess that it also depends on how wet the area became over time, because it like came and go basically. So I had also experienced some stinging with the Ordinary one. And based on that, I also did play around with the moisturizer that I used, if I should use it before or afterwards. I do feel like that when I'm using the moisturizer beforehand on the Ordinary side and then apply the azelaic acid on top, the stinging wasn't as strong and it turned into more a bit of like an itching rather than a stinging. So that's also something that I did notice, that in my case, I preferred using a moisturizer underneath with the Ordinary one, because then the stinging would calm down and it would turn into an itching kind of like feeling. Whereas with azelaic acid from Paula's Choice, it didn't even matter if I used the moisturizer before or afterwards or just left it out in that specific case. It just itches sometimes, and that's basically it. That was the experience that I had with the Paula's Choice one. But based on the pictures that I just shared with you, I mean, you can basically like make up your own mind what you think about the like comparisons and what you can see also in the pictures. But in my feeling and also how I had the experience with it, I want to stick with the Paula's Choice azelaic acid. And so this is also my experience that I want to share with you with my 1 month trial of using the Ordinary and Paula's Choice azelaic acid. I also do hope that you enjoyed this video, that you also could take something from this video with you when it comes to the information. And if you like this video, please also don't forget to give the thumbs up as well as share it. And I will see you soon in the next one. Bye and happy skin caring.